In multiple videos, I have emphasized the importance of not sticking to one question for too long. Here is a short video on explaining how to guess an answer choice better. So logically eliminate a few of the answer choices. Some examples of doing that. Look at this. If there is a question that is asking you the area or circumference of a circle or any diagram with an arc in it, the correct answer choice is likely to have a pi involved. And therefore, the answer choices which do not have a pi can be eliminated. Next, awkward numbers in PS questions. So if there's a question where the numbers I see in the question are all 12, 15, 10, 8, and they are being multiplied, divided as per whatever is the content of the question, I look at the answer choices, I see an answer choice such as 7 or 13. Now see if such numbers are involved, and especially if the context is multiplication and division, not addition or subtraction, eventually the answer that we will get would be a factor of these numbers. A number such as 7 will require a 7 somewhere here. See, there are no terms here which are a multiple of 7. Similarly, 13 would be difficult to get. A number such as 14 can also be eliminated because even a 14 would require a 7 somewhere. So such terms can be eliminated. Choices with extreme tone in all verbal questions can be eliminated. GMAT has a moderate business communication-like tone and content that would not hurt anybody with any cultural or social background, and therefore any answer choice that tends to have an extreme tone is likely to be incorrect. Next, irrelevant answer choices in CR and RC questions can be eliminated, and extremely long answer choices in sentence correction questions are also less likely to be correct. Awkward to read answer choices in sentence correction questions can also be eliminated when you are in a hurry. And then, out of the remaining answer choices, make educated guess and move forward. Some more things. In DS questions, when you are not able to solve a question and you think the answer is E, it may actually be C. Remember, question cannot be answered is different from I cannot answer the question. Next, in sentence correction questions, mark the shortest answer choice. It has a slightly higher probability of being correct. Same with RC and CR, go for the longest answer choice. In problem solving questions, look for a zero. In so many years playing with standardized examinations, I have seen that answer choices with a zero have a tad higher probability of being correct. And please remember that all of this is just to drive that extra point of luck in your favor during the exam. None of this is going to actually define your GMAT score. It's only the concepts that can get you a high score on the exam. This was the concept, guys. GMAT shorts are deliberately kept brief. For an elaborate explanation, please refer the stage 1 videos. Thanks for watching.